trees of green, red roses too. I see them bloom for me and you, and I think to myself, what a wonderful world.
Ah, yes, it is a wonderful world as Ohio State continues to rack up the commitments daily. I'm Dan Rubin. It's Thursday, June 19th, 2014. This is the Bucknuts Morning Five. We're going to spend the bulk of today's show talking with 24/7 Sports National Recruiting Analyst Steve Wiltfong about an eventful week or so and what we have coming up to look forward to at Bucknuts on the recruiting scene. Make sure today that you get to the site as quick as possible, though, and follow Bill Kerlick's live report and thread from the WAC as Ohio State finishes up another camp. Bill will have the latest. There's also a chance that Class of 2016 offensive lineman Tyler Gerald will commit today, and that's something Bill's on top of and you want to keep a close eye on. We'll have a great edition of the Boarding House today. Got some very interesting stuff in there. But now, let's not waste any more time before getting to Steve Wiltfong.
As promised, we bring in 24/7 Sports recruiting guru Steve Wiltfong. Steve, thanks for joining us. Yesterday, there was a report that Liam Eichenberg, the class of 2016, left tackle or tackle prospect out of St. Ignatius, and arguably guy's got a chance to be one of the highest-rated tackles in the state of Ohio since Alex Boone, Orlando Pace. Says that his favorite is Michigan. I think all along that kind of surprised your Bucknutters here, because there are people who really thought after his visit a few weeks ago that he was super high in Ohio State. Kind of put in context where you see the Eichenberg recruitment, you know, this early in the game.
Well, it is early, and he's taken visits, and I do think he really likes Michigan a ton. I think that he likes Ohio State a lot, and you know, I think Notre Dame is very much in the mix, too. This is, you know, one of those old-school Big Three recruiting battles. And, you know, each program is going to get Liam and his family on campus several times. And it's really, in my opinion, just too early to say where he's going to end up. And, you know, Michigan's the latest one to make a big impression. And, you know, him and his dad were up on campus earlier this week, and they had a fantastic time, obviously. And, you know, the Wolverines are definitely a player, as are the Buckeyes and the Irish. So it'll be a tight one to follow the rest of the way.
Urban Meyer has done such a good job since he got here with his first three recruiting classes, but he was always able to sell the depth chart a little bit. I think now you're getting to the point where, you know, realistically, some guys are looking at the depth chart, will see it, and it might be a little bit intimidating. Do you get the sense that out on the recruiting trail that that's hurting Ohio State at all?
No, not at all. You just switch gears. And there are still places on the depth chart to sell, as is the case with every program in the country with roster turnover. You're going to be able to sell depth chart at different positions in each recruiting class. But at the same time, now Urban Meyer and his coaching staff are selling, you know, playing on the biggest stage year in and year out, competing for national championships year in and year out. And, you know, kids are just as enamored with that, if not more, than the opportunity to play early. You know, most of these highly touted prospects think that they're going to play early anyway. And, you know, places like at Ohio State with Urban Meyer, where he has a track record of playing young guys at key positions, they know that if they come to Ohio State, they have a chance to crack the two deep and be a player as a true freshman and be a guy that's making an impact as a true freshman in Urban Meyer's program, because he's shown in the past that has happened. Even at places like Florida, when they're competing for the national championship, young guys played a huge role in that, and that'll be the case at Ohio State. And you look at Alabama, they got a chance to sign the nation's number one ranked recruiting class according to 24/7 Sports for the fifth year in a row. See, so the depth chart thing and all those arguments, you know, it doesn't work. You're just switching gears and selling titles now, and Ohio State's certainly going to be a program that I envision being in the national championship hunt every year.
That is a wonderful answer, and one that I'm sure Bucknutters worldwide will enjoy. Steve, you wrote a story yesterday that I found interesting. While Ohio State has gotten a commitment, it feels like every day now for the last week, there was a long stretch here where there was some serious panic at the disco, and you wrote something yesterday addressing that.
Well, I just finally wrote an article about it, but, you know, Dan, you and I have talked about it several times, and I think even here on this show, that there was no reason to panic or be worried, and Ohio State was not having a slow start. Yes, they weren't maybe getting commitments at the same rate as a school like Penn State, or maybe at the same rate that they have in the past couple of years, but what they were doing were getting a lot of prospects on campus to visit, a lot of their top targets. So the interest was never low. Top targets were visiting. Ohio State was considered a leader for many, many prospects, and now, you know, those kids are just now starting to pop instead of a month or two ago. These kids that Ohio State targeted in 2015 just weren't making the same early decisions. I mean, how many recruiting battles did Ohio State lose? People were talking about Ohio State not winning, getting a bunch of commitments, but how many were they losing? They really weren't losing any either, you know? So now they're starting to rack up the commits and getting the guys they want. And, you know, in my article that I wrote yesterday, you look at all the names on the board and all the guys they're considered the leader for. If they pull in 90% of those guys, they got a chance to sign the nation's number two ranked recruiting class. And I truly believe on this day, and I know there's a lot of twists and turns and things of that nature, but on this day, Ohio State's going to sign many of those guys that are in that article.
It may be an overcast day in Ohio, but the outlook is bright for Ohio State. Steve, thanks for joining us. We always appreciate you bringing the knowledge.
Thanks, Daniel.
History repeats itself. Try and you succeed. Never doubt that you're the one.